scrambled eggs. Every breakfast table has them, and every other breakfast table overcooks them. So what can we do to keep the eggs moist and fluffy? What if we add something to the eggs and help them along? That's how we're gonna come up with our ultimate scrambled eggs. Start with eggs. I'm gonna use 6 of them. You know, my students always ask me if I can do the one-handed, you know, breaking of the egg. And I always tell them, like, why? God gave us 2 hands. To this, we're gonna add some salt. Not too much, because I have a special ingredient. First, some pepper. And something to help it along, keep it moist and creamy, some evaporated milk. That's about 1/2 a regular can. That should be enough for 6 eggs. We're gonna give this a good whisk. And now, our special ingredient. Pork floss. You've probably seen this on bread. So it's actually meat that's been cut up and then dried. So you're gonna get that meaty texture without that heaviness. So it's very light, but it has all the flavor of the meat that you want. So we're gonna put this on standby because once we cook those eggs, we gotta keep going and going and going. I'm gonna heat up the pan with a little bit of oil. And it's important to use a non-stick pan this time. Let's not make things hard for ourselves. Swirl that around. Don't start with a pan that's too hot. Give yourself a chance. So there you go. And the key to fluffy scrambled eggs is to keep mixing. And actually, when you're gonna cook an omelet, you start with the same thing. You put all your eggs in, and then you keep mixing. Just make sure you get the sides as well. So you see that the egg actually starts cooking from the outside, going to the inside. So you want to get these cooked eggs from the outside, scrape them, and move them towards the middle. So actually, by starting with low heat, we're doing that fancy thing that the chefs call like coddling the eggs or something like that. So you see the egg is starting to form. When you've got a good number of that solid egg forming, we can add our pork floss. You can add as much as you want, but of course, too much of it will make it salty. There you go. Just keep mixing. If you don't have evaporated milk, you can actually add some cream to it as well. I just like the flavor of evaporated milk. It has a little bit more sweetness. And we're almost there. You see, it looks really raw and uncooked, but there's a lot of heat in the pan already. So it's actually time to shut off the heat in about 30 seconds. And that's it. After you shut it off, take it away from the heat because it's actually gonna keep cooking. And then we plate. That is it. Ultimate scrambled eggs, less than 5 minutes. Let's give it a taste. Look at that, soft, fluffy. It's a smooth, velvety, a little bit sweet from that evaporated milk. Actually, it's so soft, you don't have to bite it. You can actually just press it with your tongue and just swallow it. So good. What's the most rewarding thing to do on a weekend? For me, it's preparing something special for my family and knowing I had put my heart in every dish on the table. Everything's set? Time to wake everybody up and let them in on the treat.